Can a Chromebook get a virus or malware? Well, we'll discover this in today's video. From Selma Teacher 7, Mr. Barry here, so let's get going. Hey, here I am in my Chromebook. I don't see any viruses or malware in here, but of course, I'm not an antivirus program. So why am I doing this video today? Because a subscriber named Minor Pear brought up this topic. Can a Chromebook get a virus? So here's a shout out to Minor Pear and King Cat. And before I forget, let me remind you to please click on thumbs up if you like this video, comment down below because I love to read your comments, and subscribe to my channel, clicking on the bell icon to receive notifications of new videos and share the videos. Now back to the question, can a Chromebook get a virus? According to Malware-bytes, who sell antivirus software, they say yes. But a quick Google search will bring up a bit of info. So here's what I found. Chromebooks are inherently secure and have no viruses. They are very secure and aren't susceptible to any known viruses. This is because each web page and Chrome app runs inside its own virtual sandbox, meaning other aspects of the computer can't be compromised by a single infected page. Okay. So, which is it? Can a Chromebook get a virus? Well, to answer that, we need to dig a little deeper on what a virus is and where a Chromebook can be vulnerable. First, I should probably mention that malware is a general term for items that are found in these two broad categories that I've listed here for us. The very first line that we see at the top is viruses. These are boot sector, macro, overwrite, web scripting, direct action, resident, and multipartite. Below that we have Trojan horses, worms, and adware. And then we have bloatware finishing off that category. Now the second category we have spyware, browser hijacks, phishing sites, ransomware, and fileless malware. Windows PCs can be infected by any from this list, but Chromebooks cannot. This is because a Chrome operating system prevents changes to the system through the use of write-only CMOS chips, so traditional viruses simply cannot get into the Chrome OS system to change things around, and they cannot block access or erase files. With that being said, Chromebooks are still vulnerable to browser hijacks, phishing sites, ransomware, file-less malware, and far less common, even spyware from Android apps. This is because code within third-party browser extensions can change the browser's settings, resulting in the browser loading a different home page, loading ransomware, or other annoying pop-up window, or even allowing spyware through a third-party Android app or extension. Also, Android apps are great on a Chromebook, but they can contain code that can lead them to become spyware. The thing is, Chromebooks are nearly invulnerable to any items in the top part of our virus list. Things like Trojans, worms, adware, bloatware, this is because of the lockdown and secure nature of the Chrome operating system. Now, with that being said, Chromebooks are still extremely safe and almost 100% secure. So if your Chromebook begins acting strange, a traditional type of virus is not the cause. It is most likely your browser was hijacked by an extension. These hijacks can result in all sorts of confusion for the user because suddenly they expect one website to load and another page loads in its place. Or an annoying pop-up window keeps popping up every 15 seconds. A person might really believe that their Chromebook has a virus, but remember, it is most likely a browser hijack. The good news is that it's very easy to fix these problems. Simply remove the offending extension or app. So to remove these, simply click on the three dots found in the upper right-hand corner of the screen. And I'm pointing to them now. Go to More Tools, then Extensions. From there, you can select the extension that you wish to remove and remove it. So here, you actually see me doing those steps and looking at my extensions. Now let's say I want to remove one of these extensions. Notice what I do there. When I click it, you have the option to remove it and I'm zooming in so you can see it clearly. If you click on remove or uninstall, then that extension is off your machine and so is your problem. So how do extensions and apps go bad? As you may know, you can add extensions and apps from the Chrome Web Store. As you can see here, here's the Chrome Web Store. Items found here must go through a large amount of scrutiny where the code is checked to make sure that it's safe. And things like spyware, browser hijacks, and phishing sites are screened out and blocked from being part of any extension or app before they are added to the Chrome Web Store. But criminals found a way in. They discovered that they first submit a clean extension, they are allowed later to go in and update it. And when they updated their extension, that's when they added the malware. Google has recently discovered this practice and has changed the rules. Now both the original submits and the updates are screened for malware, and if a company is caught adding malware to their software, they are banned from the Chrome Web Store. This has led to hundreds of software titles disappearing from the Chrome Web Store and from user accounts. But the world is a safer place for it. So if you notice that one or more of your apps has disappeared from the shelf, that's why. Now, criminals being criminals, they found another way to try to get their infected extensions onto your Chromebook, and that is by offering them through another web page. For this reason, please download only third-party extensions that are found on the Chrome Web Store, and don't use other websites to get your extensions. Another pitfall are phishing websites. These are websites that may look legit, but in fact are not. Here's an example. You receive an email that looks like it's from B of A, but when you click on the link that is found within the email, instead of going to bankofamerica.com, it loads a page that looks almost like Bank of America, but in the URL box at the top, it says www.bankofamerica12345.com or something else. The page looks right, but the URL on the top is all wrong. Also, the padlock, which should always be closed, signifying that your data is being encrypted, is wide open. If you ever see this, then close the page. Never enter a username or password into a site if you notice that the padlock is unlocked. That is a sign of trouble. So always be aware of it and the URL address. This is where your personal information can be stolen. File-less malware or ransomware can be loaded as well. If you see a ransom claiming that your data is locked out, immediately close that pop-up window and tab, or the website that is loading the pop-up. If it returns, check your extensions and remove any new or suspicious extensions. If all else fails, you can always perform a Powerwash on the Chromebook, and it will take everything back to the factory settings. The computer will restart, then you can log back into your Chrome account and everything should be good to go. Let me show you the steps on how to perform a Powerwash on your Chromebook. First, let me jump to the other side of my Chromebook. Now, click on the time. Then click on the gear icon. A new window should open within this window. You will see a search box. Click in there and key in the word Powerwash. The Powerwash feature will pop up down below. Now click on it to begin this process. There will be a few confirmation windows that you'll need to go through. Once the system does the Powerwash, you will need to set it up, just like it was the very first time that you turned on the Chromebook. You'll need to enter in your Wi-Fi password, your Google account, and your Google password to get back in. But once you have done that, your apps like Google Drive, Docs, Sheets, Photos, Data will all load again. Let me jump to the other side now. Now, is there another way that criminals can get into your private data and info? And the answer is yes, and that's through Google Docs add-ons. Again, any add-on must go through a procedure and certification process before being added to Google Docs add-ons list. But after the add-on list has been added to your Google Docs app, it may be later updated with malicious code. Now, Microsoft Office also has the same vulnerability where it can contain add-ons that have malicious code from third-party updates. For this reason, it is recommended that you remove any unused third-party add-ons from Google Docs and Microsoft Word. Add-ons created and maintained by either Google or Microsoft are safe, and you do not need to remove them even when they're not being used. Now here's the next question. Can your Chromebook be hacked? Anything is possible, I guess, but really that really depends on how you use your Chromebook. If you only surf safe sites, that is sites that have the closed padlocks in the URL address box, you never download any suspicious apps or Chrome extensions from third-party websites, and you always keep your Chromebook updated, then your Chromebook will probably never get hacked. But there is always a very small chance, just like there is a chance of you being struck by a local meteorite, asteroid, or comet impact, which has the odds of about 1 in 1.6 million. Now, on to more complicated stuff. Android apps. Android apps that are found within the Play Store go through the same rigorous scrutiny that the extensions go through. So why is there a problem? Because once an Android app is on your Chromebook, it may receive updates that may turn it into a spybot machine. Now, for this reason, it is recommended that you update Android apps only through the Play Store and not from third-party websites. Now, what if you think that you already have an infected Android app? You may simply uninstall it. That can be done by following these steps. First, go to the app launcher, then locate the app, right-click it, and then select uninstall or remove. Now, do you wish to prevent having a good app go bad? You may install Malware-bytes Security from the Play Store, and it can scan other apps and keep your security top-notch. According to Malware-bytes, they update this free program and make sure that it can find apps that have been compromised. If you feel that one or more of your Android apps already contain malicious coding, then Malware-bytes Security can scan it and remove it from them. Hey, and that's my video on security for your Chromebook. Now, a number of students have also mentioned this, such as Jean and Anna. They kind of talked about, well, is the Chromebook really safe and all this. Hopefully that's answered your question and now you feel safer with your Chromebook. And if not, you know how to scan it and how to keep it safe. Hey, again, please, if you like this video, please click on thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. And comment down below because I love to read your comments. Thank you again and bye-bye.